Welcome to This Is Important, a production of iHeartRadio, the show where we talk about what's obviously most critically, crucially important.
Today on This Is Important,
Dursey's uterus cups.
How did somebody not scoop your little fleshlight ass up?
Whatever you do, don't walk in a room with a dick in your hand.
Strap in.
Yeah!
Yeah! Yas, kings!
Yeah! Okie dokie!
Tight butthole
is a bagel.
Wow, right, dude!
Marching. Back. Yeah. Marching Gortat.
Oh, man. And
do we have a song that would really kick it off?
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
that's kind of your thing. Yeah,
so yeah. Okay. What, hit us with it.
What would it be?
Hit us with it, Blakey.
Let's see.
Give it.
No, this is not it.
What is this?
Wait, no, let that ride. What is this?
What is this?
This,
well,
is
this isn't kicking it off. This is
that's winding it down. Play this at the end.
Fuck you guys.
Oh my.
That was random.
Okay.
Nobody's supposed to be here.
Take me to church.
Is that from Waiting to Exhale? Or I don't know. Damn, that's a great track.
It seems like it should be.
I think it's from a soundtrack, but that movie or that track rocked.
Adam, do we jump right into talking about the definition in Blake's arms right now? Like, what are we looking at here?
Okay.
Okay. Sorry, Andre Iguodala.
Wow, okay. My boy. Corey Maggette, I'll shoot you back a clipper. A little Corey Maggette over here.
Thank you.
How about this one? Merriam-Webster, because my man's got definition.
Ooh. Oh, okay. I was like, for a second, I thought
flex
you were.
Flex for us, dog. Flex
I
for
thought
us.
You were.
Let's see it. Let's see it. Okay.
Look at that. And now the other one? Hair. Is the other one way smaller?
No, this is my strong one.
Yeah, let's also talk about your pit hair, because you've always had very dense pit hair.
Yeah, dude. That's the only place other than my head.
Now, do you think have the biggest arms and lemmings now?
Whoa.
No, not at all. You still got the cannons, brother.
No, Kyle's got them. Wobble, wobble.
Yeah, Kyle's got those teacher arms.
The bummer about the bummer about my arms is they're never as shredded looking. They're they're just big. They're big
meat
and beefy.
Cannons. They're cannons.
They're real meat cannons. But but I don't got that sweet, sweet shredded death that you got, baby.
And let's see the back. Do you have the goat hoof?
Oh, see that? I don't know.
Yeah.
It might be the lighting, but your triceps you look mad, Dookie.
Yeah.
Adam's
triceps
have
kickbacks.
Always had that like little lump on the side.
Mm-hmm. I got a power lump.
You know, like you just got a shot or something. Like you're.
It's not a tumor.
You're going abroad.
I was super pumped when I got my COVID vaccine. first time.
You what?
Yeah. I'm one of those believers in COVID.
You stupid dumbass.
wow.
Yeah. I don't know. I'm crazy like that. I just doctors and stuff. I sort of believe in them. But
I'm a dumbass.
It's. Science.
I just listen to science.
I just listen to the doctors, and I don't know. But
okay.
It's science.
Okay.
They
and then you went blind. Interesting.
She was putting it into my arm, and she was like, "Please stop flexing." And I'm
ooh.
Like,
oh.
"I'm like,
nice.
I'm not."
Ooh.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Oh.
Yeah. Ooh.
Never was Chloe heard me say it. Like she was getting the shot right next to me. It was like a line of people. And he was like, Jesus Christ, I've never seen you look more proud. It was won the Emmy.
Like,
I was like,
relax.
No, she's like, honestly, though, like your muscles are spazzing and your veins are like really fucked up. You should go to the hospital.
Yeah, you should go to the hospital.
If you're
can
not
you see
flexing,
right now?
You're fucked, dude.
You're high as a kite on pre-workout right now, aren't you?
Your blood is so thick, it's like goo. It's not good. Your veins are struggling.
Her saying that to you, and then you kind of walk away stoked, and then like a 12-year-old sits down, and she's like, hey, can you stop flexing?
Hey, stop.
And you're like, fuck! And you realize it's just her line to like little boys.
I don't give a fuck!
Yeah. Hey. She thought I was a child.
Wow, look at these muscles.
"Oh, hey, big boy." That's what she did, say, "Hey, big boy," and patted the seat when I sat down. So
right at the top of your head.
She gave me a lollipop when I left, so maybe.
Here you go. Would you like a little Pokemon sticker?
There you go.
And we're going to put a little Paw Patrol Band-Aid on you.
Oh, hey.
And you're done.
Do you want Marshall or do you want another one I can't name?
And someone was like, "You know he's not 10. And I'm like, "I know, but he's
his brain.
Slow, right?"
Mm-hmm. Right.
I wrote, "Does Adam Devine have" in Google, and it filled in the rest for me.
Yeah, I'm aware of who he is.
He did ask for a lolly afterwards, but okay.
A dum-dum.
Lollipop.
Dude, shout out to dum-dums.
I will say that my, speaking of, speaking of being a fucking idiot, my fucking balls, dude.
Okay. Now, speaking of balls, should I buzz ball off? Should I buzz off?
I don't know. Last week got kind of crazy.
Dude, treat yourself to another buzz.
Wait a
buzzing,
minute.
Buddy.
Oh, dear God.
And should we talk about Kyle's speech or no? Kyle's Emmy speech?
No, we shouldn't talk about his speech.
I just reached into the buzz box and I pulled out something I did not want.
Are they cold this week?
They're not cold. They're still very hot.
You still didn't put them in the fridge, you fool.
They're still hot. Oh God, it's one of my least favorite things. It's
a chili mango.
Yeah, it's a spicy brew.
Yeah.
It's a spicy brew.
I'm not a big mango fan.
Feel free to reach in again. We're not pressuring you to have the chili mango, or are we, Durs?
But I will say this, because if you drink all the good ones at first, then you're going to be stuck with just all the bad ones, and you're not going to want to throw them away.
But then you can give them to your children.
Is this better? Is this better?
That is not better. Warm.
What is that one?
Should I have had a milk product sitting in the heat this long?
No. Absolutely, that's not better. Go chili mango. 100%.
Chocolate? Is that supposed to be like a Kahlua, like mudslide?
It must be. I think it's
the cause of diarrhea.
But anyways, okay, I'm going to chili mango it and then Devine.
The delay on that. You searching for that button.
Download us about your balls while I slurp this ball.
Oh, okay, yes. I Snapchatted that memory. I was like, what were we talking about?
Yeah.
Your testicles.
What was I about to say? Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. My nuts.
Just go to your default thought.
Oh, yeah, the nuts.
Because it's, you know how for like well over a month now, it feels like someone has kicked me in the nuts just a few minutes ago.
Yeah, which has got to be a terrible feeling.
It's the worst. I can't do anything. I'm not even having sex. Chloe's super bummed at me. Cause she loves getting it.
I bet. as he looks over to make sure she is super bummed.
You are bummed. She's like, yes.
I wish you were like, and weirdly she seems
yummy.
Like oddly satisfied still.
Yeah, she's somehow really cool. Yes. I don't know why she says she's floating through every room.
I don't know what's going on.
She's dealing with it well.
No, so I have to have a heat pad on my balls at all time. Oh, and I'm God. Like working a lot right now on Gemstone. So
and what happened to yourself?
So like 6 months ago when I was doing the show in Berlin.
Bumper.
I was like, it's Bumper in Berlin. Mm. It's a spin-off show about my character from the Pitch Perfect movies.
Legend, mate.
And so I'm like singing and dancing. I'm a song and dance man. Once again, I'm jiggling all over. Uh-huh. And I like did my classic kick my foot up, do the foot swipe maneuver that I do.
We know it well. We know it well.
Yes.
I know you guys do.
Yes.
And
point the toe.
Points. And I just, my body went
joints
like, in my lower like top dick region, which we've talked about this.
I felt
it rip. And they did an ultrasound. Right. There is a tear there. They're like, just don't.
And I'm pregnant.
don't use it a lot.
Twins.
But I kind of didn't stop working out, you know, because I'm a fucking idiot. And
well, you were busy.
And I had to keep doing the show, and I still worked out every day, trying not to do things that would hurt me, but still kind of hurting myself. And it felt better. That was like 6 months ago. And then a month, right. like a little over a month ago, I re-hurt myself working out thinking I'm fully good.
What movement were you doing?
I was doing deadlifts.
Go. Okay.
And it just fucking it whopped me. and now I'm just fucked. So I go to a doctor. They do another ultrasound, which was hilarious, by the way. It was like a 35-year-old girl, like a woman who's like our age.
Do not come.
Who is putting hot goo on my balls. Just me and her in this room. It's super awkward. Hot goo on my ball.
Do not come. Balls,
and rubbing the little wand on it. And then just asking me like,
does that feel good?
questions about my career. She was a big Workaholics fan. She liked Modern Family a lot.
Yeah.
So that was super weird.
Right.
Naked grandma!
And then now there's evidently fluid in my right testicle. So
oh, fuck.
They're
going to... In the testicle?
Yeah.
What? I'm sorry to laugh. Dude, what? Wait, what? What?
I don't know. But the internet says that shouldn't be too painful, but I am in a lot of pain. So
what internet? Like Reddit? Like where are you looking? Are you looking in your comment section of Instagram?
So now I have to go to a urologist and they couldn't get me into a urologist for another week. So I have to like live this life for a whole other week, which is so cool.
I think a homie of mine in high school had this same thing happen. He thought he was pulling his groin all the time, and then he got it checked out and found out he had fluid. I don't know if he had his ball removed.
Is that a hernia?
No.
What?
I can't remember if he had his ball removed, but he definitely had to have a surgery where they went in there and did something.
They said it could be surgery. Now.
Yeah. Let me see it. I'll see if it's the same.
Okay.
You want to see it? That was like.
You want to see it?
That was decades ago, Anders. We might have advanced in medical surgery by now.
Either way, I got to see it.
Nope.
Come on.
Not today.
Let's take a look at it.
And so you've just been sitting around with a heat pad on it, huh?
On your job.
Yeah. It actually feels all right now. But
Let me see.
Yeah. Sometimes, usually later on in the day. Like by the end of the day, I'm laying there and I have to have the heat pad on it.
We'll FaceTime later.
It really sucks.
Because like more fluid gets down there by the end of the day. Is it kind of like when you weigh yourself in the morning, there's no fluid?
I have no idea.
You gotta learn the science of your body, dude.
Mm-hmm. I should probably take a look.
Science.
Well, I can't because as soon as I start to web MD it, I'm like, oh, my nut is going to twist itself in a knot and fall off. Like,
well, do you feel like better?
That's what it said on my MD.
It told me to put a chip clip on the tip of my nut sack and just kind of see what happens.
Tostitos chip clip.
Does your balls feel better in the morning, at night? Like, when is it the most filled with fluid, if you had to say.
It's I feel like there's no rhyme or reason to it. Sometimes I'm like, sometimes it'll hurt so
baby, there ain't
bad.
No rhyme or reason to my dick, baby. You're gonna love this.
Ball. And sometimes it'll feel great, and then other balls. Times I'm like, oh, it feels like I was just kicked in the nuts by a person with a...
You gotta stop theragunning your balls, dude.
With a pointy-toed shoe.
It feels better.
It really sucks. So,
yo, remember the video we watched in the Workaholics writers' room of like a guy's nutsack getting boxed through a hole?
Yes, we definitely talked about this. We could talk about it again.
Yeah, please. I love
speed bagging his nuts.
That's what it feels like.
Do you think that would help or make it worse?
I bet it wouldn't. If just right now, just thinking about that, I don't think it would help. But I'm willing to give it a shot for TII Nation.
By the way, any movie where somebody speeds bag nuts is my favorite movie.
I think there's just a handful.
I know, but they're
a
like,
handful.
We got to speed bag it.
Wait, are we talking about motion pictures or is Anders talking about
movies? Not internet clips.
Pornographic movies.
No, legit movies where somebody's doing bada 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 bing.
I think it's Hot Shots Part 2, maybe.
Wait, you mean an actual nutsack or a It's just a speed bag.
We literally did it in Workaholics where, yeah, like Durs has numbing spray.
Yes, that is right.
Because I think we saw it on Hot Shots.
And then somebody's phone went off. Didn't you hit it and somebody's phone went off on set? And we were like, kind of perfect.
Wait. And we kept it.
We're and, like, then, or, and then we added it in post.
Yeah.
Or did it, or I'm, wait, did, or
we
did
wrote
we,
it in.
I think we wrote it. Yes, we I did. Think we wrote it.
Is that right?
Yeah, yes, because we're like, it has to ding when we hit it. And we're like, why would that ever happen? And we're like, what if somebody's phone went off right when you hit it? And then so like we go, whoa, did your phone go off?
Please keep your phone off. I remember loving that bit. And then we, like the three of us lost our minds when that happened, like on the day. Like these three fucking idiots were like, oh.
Yeah. And, you know, it didn't go down in history, but we're still talking about it.
Hey, man. Hey, funny show.
Hey,
they should do a movie. Huh? We're writing it.
I'll buzzball to that, man. This one goes out to you.
Hey, way to show us not the, the buzzball. Thank you.
No, it's, I would love to.
He's just showing, actually, us like the,
I have to show
the
you
nutrition
the
information, the Surgeon General's warning about buzzballs. Thanks, man. Yeah. Does it cause cancer? I don't know. What,
well, hey, there are some cool facts about buzzballs company that I'd love to let you know.
Okay. Oh, please.
It's, I think it's we've got time for none.
It's a Texas company, and it's also, it's women-owned. It says on the box, it's women-owned, which is pretty freaking sick.
I don't know if I like that. Buzz balls?
What? We got some, these are,
ball,
you're
so
right.
Women are moving into the ball sphere?
Oh, and you don't like that?
I guess it's okay.
Okay,
everything's changing.
Go off, queen.
Okay, here we go. I'm going to buzz it up. Let's, it's
Dursey's uterus cups.
Okay, hit it up, up.
Is this your,
oh my God.
Slamming it.
Yeah.
I don't like that.
Well,
I don't like the chili.
So you don't like a woman-owned company?
Yeah.
Is that what you're saying?
So you're saying you don't like
woman-owned company.
No,
okay.
I do. I just don't.
And that's been well documented now.
Okay.
Allegedly.
I don't think the chili mango is my flavor.
Dude. Allegedly. Dude, dare you.
No, it's done. We went past it. We went past it, and we're back.
I think you got to chase it with the chocolate one.
As I sweat out of my face. Like, it's not even from my forehead. It's sweating out of, like, my under eyes at that point.
Yeah.
I might have a problem.
And is that from the chili mango, or that's because it's still 111 degrees?
A little bit of both.
Wait, did you shake it well?
I love that you guys are in the same city. Not that far from each other, a little distance, but not too far. Yeah. Durs is currently wearing a sweater.
Yeah.
Blake is sweating.
It's called a sweatshirt.
Yeah.
Wearing a sweatshirt. Blake is sweating, wearing a tank top, and he doesn't have his AC on still, right? Mm-hmm. A week later.
Flex your power.
Okay. Are you going to turn it on today?
I will after 9 o'clock. After or actually, now it's 10 o'clock. Newsom says we can't turn it off till after 10.
After 10 a.m.
No, p.m. Peak hours. Peak hours.
So, that doesn't make sense to me because it cools off at night. So just open your windows all night long.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, night is when you can. During the day is when you need the AC.
Exactly. Peak hours. And you're not allowed to run your AC during peak hours.
But the peak hours, if everybody's allowed to turn it on at the same time later, then that becomes the peak hour.
Yeah, but it's exactly what you're saying. At that point, it's cool. So really what he's saying is you're not allowed to run your fucking shit, okay?
Okay, but yeah, but also, he's not the fucking boss of you, dude. Just fucking fire up that AC. Just put
don't
it
let him
downstairs.
Bow to Newsom.
Don't let him govern your life.
I pray allegiance to Newsom.
Just put it on downstairs where you're at. Don't do the whole house because you have you. It's
I have it on in my this room only.
Okay, yeah, that's the way to do it.
I don't have what would you call that? Central heating? How do you do like room by room?
Oh, yours is
there. It's got like I don't know.
Mine's all or nothing.
Nothing.
Yeah.
Nathan, for you?
Okay. Yeah. In LA, I have an upstairs and a downstairs unit. So.
Right.
Yes. Yeah. I should have that.
I have like a splitter. A splitter for like four different sections of the crib.
You got to get yourself a splitter, dog.
Right.
Yeah. I do.
I think didn't I send you my guy?
You did.
Yeah.
You did.
Okay, so
and he didn't give you the splitter?
So did you not get a splitter?
Shout out Daniel, the AC dude.
Bro, HVAC man. King. HVAC rocks and it needs to be done, and we're marching towards that.
You didn't pay for AC, did you, Blake?
Right.
I was a little late. And uh-huh. We're almost through it, and we're gonna get through it, and it's gonna be okay.
Are you a climate warrior? Is that what's happening?
No. Blake is just cheap. He's not a climate warrior. He's just a cheap fuck.
I just want to party.
He's a party warrior.
I remember you guys being so,
you know what,
like legitimately mad at me when we.
I'm gonna fight back. Go ahead. Go off.
When we lived together. Everyone was legit, and it wasn't just you, it was also Kyle and Adam mm-hmm. and Haley, our mm-hmm. other roommates.
Yeah.
They're legit, they all had work. Uh-huh. And we did have a one side of the house, other side of the house situation mm-hmm. at the Workaholics house.
Mm-hmm. You had a splitter?
We had a splitter. And I just cooled the side that was my bedroom, and it was, I'm home, I
just say it, just say the words.
I didn't have a job. And it was 112 degrees.
He's improvising.
Yeah.
I'm riffing, dude. It was 112 degrees. I'm home alone.
Your audition?
I'm auditioning for Home Alone.
I was like, I can't fucking stand this. So I turned the AC on just on my side of the house, and they were furious.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, bro, because we were
so mad at me.
Well, these guys are from the, listen, these guys are from the Bay. We're like,
okay, say it again.
where you don't need AC up there, right? Mm-hmm. You guys didn't grow up with AC.
No. The Bay Area gets extremely fucking hot.
For like 2 hours of the day.
It doesn't get extremely fucking hot.
Well, not San Francisco is climate cool, but we are outside of the city in like the suburbs. It gets so motherfucking hot.
Oh, so now you're admitting it.
So you're not
okay,
from the
Bay. We finally caught you. Because uh-huh. you guys for years, I was like, where are you guys from? Before I visited their home, they were like, yeah, Oakland, basically. Yeah, Oakland. And I'm like, oh, shit, Oakland. Okay, these fucking guys are from
Bakersfield. Bakersfield counts.
Oakland. And damn. Then I went and visited. And I'm like, dude, this is almost identical to my suburban upbringing in Omaha, Nebraska. I'm like,
minus the sweltering heat.
Dude, I'm a Bay Area inclusionist. I'll say San Jose is the Bay, Sacramento is the Bay. I'll go all the way to San Diego is the Bay Area.
But okay.
Worldwide Bay. Okay. Worldwide Bay, okay?
Okay, uh-huh. But you didn't say the Bay. You guys would say Oakland, and I'm like, oh, you guys are from Oakland. And then I get there and I'm like, this is Concord, California. This isn't Oakland at all. Right. I'm like, okay, ooh. Well, where's Oakland? Let's go there. Maybe we go out there tonight. Right. And you guys are like, oh, that is an hour away.
Yeah. Really far.
No. Please, no.
No, we're going to go to a bar with cowboy boots stapled to the ceiling.
Clayton.
Oh, shout my out God. Clayton.
Well, dude, okay. So the way I...
You were like, this is where Tom Hanks grew up?
The way I have told people where I'm from has evolved. But when you're in Los Angeles and you're describing...
You mean the truth has surfaced?
The truth has... Come on.
Come on, dude. Durs, you probably say I'm from Chicago.
I don't, and you know that about me.
You probably used to.
Never did.
Okay, fine. Durs, and here's your gold, here's your sign. But look,
I'm just saying, I'm not from there.
Okay, so if you go, hey, I'm from, there's, hey, where are you from? Evanston. And people are like, Evanston, England? Where the fuck is Evanston? Nobody's ever heard of that.
Yeah,
you say Illinois, you say Illinois.
And by the way, this is like a litmus test for somebody who actually wants to know where I'm from or not. If I go, I'm from Evanston, Illinois.
No one actually wants to know.
That's crazy.
Hey, Durs. I did.
I'm saying if you're not trying to have a whole fucking geography lesson, there's like you give people the basic idea.
But the easy follow up is, where's that? And I go, it's just outside Chicago, Illinois. And they go, oh, okay, cool. Or they know Northwestern.
Yes, I've evolved towards that.
Or they're huge Jeremy Piven fans, guys. You act like this shit doesn't happen.
Here's your sign.
They're huge fans of the Piv. Yeah,
I've evolved towards that. Now I tell people, if they say, hey, where are you from? I say, oh, like Bay Area, East Bay, Concord, California.
No, well, what it is, if you wouldn't...
Just say Concord, where Tom Hanks is not from.
And then say Concord, New Hampshire. There's more than one Concord.
I know. And then you just go, no, actually, California. I'm from the Bay.
Blake, if you didn't become successful and famous to where people actually know the truth, you would have never evolved. It's the fact that someone for sure called you out. Someone was like, "Right, where are you from?" And you're like...
Where were you on 9/11?
Oakland. And he's like, no, you're from Concord, dude. And you're like,
huh.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Huh. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I am.
Huh. I wish Kyle was here.
Freaking see ya.
I feel like he could speak on this.
That makes one of us.
But yeah.
You know what? Part of it was, yes, I need to represent specifically Concord, put Concord more on the map, like, because it is important. To me?
This is important?
This is important to
but,
me?
By the way, I'm out here raising awareness. I'm already repping it.
I see you in your sweater, you motherfucker. Flex your power, you son of a bitch. You need to turn that fucking shit off because I'm sweating.
You need to sweat. It's 112 degrees.
And I'm sweating through my tank top. Trash talk.
Trash talk. Represent.
Yeah, this is...
Hold it up in a more harder way to read. There. Yeah, okay, cool. Great, got it.
There you go. Yeah, you are sweating so badly right now, dude.
Bro, the mango chili buzzball is fucking with me.
Hit in.
What is the temperature right now, currently where you're at?
I mean, it has to...
Can you turn on the AC and just see what it reads inside your home?
89 out here.
I bet you're...
I'm going to be honest. I pulled the AC unit off the wall. It's incapable.
86.
We're at least at 90.
It's 90. It's 90 in LA where you're at.
Okay. It's one of the cooler days.
Evanston, Illinois, it's 80 degrees.
Yeah. Well, how is it in Concord, New Hampshire?
Well, I have my shit set up. You look at your own damn phone.
Okay, well, can you check Concord, New Hampshire?
77 in Madison. I bet it's a beautiful day.
Okay, and this is weather talk.
Join us on
new
This
low.
Is Important for Weather Talk.
A new...
64 in Vancouver.
A new segment here
that
on
shit's important.
This is important.
If you thought luggage...
If you liked luggage talk...
If you thought pickleball was an exciting sport...
And if you couldn't get enough of tech talk...
Welcome to Weather Talk.
Oh, it's raining in Mobile.
Shout out to Mobile. I know right now, I know this is like...
Mobile, Alabama.
3 weeks away, but if it's still raining, we see you and we're sorry it's raining out there.
By the way, when I was in Mobile, they go, did you know that this is the rainiest place in the United States over Seattle?
It's a rainforest.
It blew my mind, and I said, I got to share that on the pod.
Shut up. You're like, shut up. I have to get on
that
the pod.
Shit's important.
I have to get on the pod five Stop. Months later, and
I gotta go.
Shut up.
I got
to
keep it 100.
Okay, Five to six months later, I have to get on the pod and tell my boys about this.
I ran right off a dolphin.
I do remember what I wanted to say, though, and half of the reason why I don't turn my shit on.
Look how close he is to the camera right now. Back the fuck up, man. I don't need all that.
I do. I do, Blake. Lean in.
Look, I got to get up on this mic. The weather is only going to get more...
We got a climate warrior.
I am preparing my family.
Okay, Leonardo DiCaprio.
I am preparing my family for not only blackouts of electricity. But even hotter weather.
Well, preparing them by preparing them by buying a generator for your home?
Do you drive a Prius?
Okay.
No, because if you get a generator, it's all going away. It's what? Doomsday. We're doomsday prepping right now.
See, no, no, no. It's your frugality that is that nice. You're dealing with. It's not. Mm. It's not. You're not a doomsday prepper.
No.
Here's the deal.
All this is a facade. You'd rather say you're a doomsday prepper than saying you're a little. Right.
Daddy prepped us for doomsday. We got a box of buzzballz. If you're cold, drink one of these. You'll sweat out the bottom of your eyes.
Drink a buzzballz. It'll warm you right up.
If you're hot, if you're cold, drink one. If you're hot, drink one.
No matter the temp, if we get drunk enough, we won't feel it.
Oh my God.
Ay, ay, ay.
I like how you're like, look, we got to prepare for this. Or just like, we're problem solving. We're figuring out ways. Like, yeah, get there's that no. Tesla Powerwall put in the crib, man.
I'm going to get a generator for my house, I think. I think I am. Same. Because they're saying like these, that we're going to start getting like
rolling blackouts.
Not and I have. Bet it's going to be a normal thing in L.A. now.
Because Durs is running his... Oh, yeah, because people don't...
And imagine you have, like, Durs has a Tesla. You're like, and suddenly you, like, can't drive your fucking car. You can't go anywhere.
Exactly.
I'll find a way.
Like, get the generator.
It's quite the catch-22, isn't it?
Get the generator.
Yep.
That's what you got to do. Get the Jenny.
Wow. I don't know, man.
Jenny, I got your number.
Oh, you don't? What do you mean? You don't know?
I just think with every solution, we're creating other problems.
Okay, so, but if you get a generator, then you can generate enough electricity to power your home for weeks and weeks.
Let's get the solar roofs.
So we're speaking about just us. I'm talking globally. I just think we need a global solution.
Oh, so you want to control everyone? Is that what you want to do? You want to tell everyone what to do?
No, I don't want to control everyone, man.
Lead by example.
Hey, but Blake, you're not in charge, though. You're only in charge of your home.
I know I'm not, but I can only do what I do.
Climate warrior.
But how do you have to lead by example, don't you?
That's what I just said.
But so you're leading by example is just not
sensitive. Sitting in the heat.
Sitting in the heat and the dark with your family while your food.
Yes, like maybe a Native American would do. I want to do it the old school way. I want to do it the old school way. Huh. No electricity.
Interesting.
Your new infant, your infant baby.
Other than my ring light.
is just boiling hot because it's 115 degrees.
No, dude. Okay. We keep the baby room cool, dude. I turn when it.
Okay.
Oh, so you do have a splitter.
Oh.
No.
Interesting.
Come on, man. No, I got a system figured out.
There's a bunch of buzzballz under the crib.
There's a lot of holes in your story.
Now you're pulling back the facade. If you want to see the Undertaker talk, come on, man. But look, man, I'm playing a character right now. A little bit.
Of a climate warrior?
Not really. I'm sweating.
I know.
Are you spritzing your shirt below camera with water? Man, it's really hot here. It's a bit, guys. Okay.
It is really hot.
Yeah, your 9-year-old daughter is underneath the table spritzing you.
Daddy, am I doing good?
I feel like at this point I'm now it's a flop sweat out of like anxiety because I'm being backed into a corner. By the way, good. I got diagnosed recently.
With what? Anxiety?
No, my therapist says I have ADD.
Sure.
Sure. This is like everybody does.
You guys are just like sure. That was like a huge revelation.
Why do people not know what they have?
Well, also you're
also I need to shave my head.
Just shave the back of your neck so it's a buzz.
So this is new. You're going to a therapist like Tony Soprano?
Wait, did Tony have ADD?
No, Tony goes to a therapist.
I thought you were going
to
say, wait, did Tony go to a therapist?
Sensitive.
No, went to a therapist, dude. So you're going. How often do you go to this therapist? This
every Monday.
Really? Every week?
Yeah. I mean, what? Dude, this isn't fucking...
I know. Stop. Yeah. This is... every week?
Yeah. I know you have never, but...
No, I've never.
I go individual, couple, you name it, I'll do it. But This is the first time I've been told I have ADD.
Rando. I'll just crash somebody else's therapy session.
That's great. And they can, I didn't know.
I'll just go talk to a homeless man and be like, tell me what's wrong with me, brother.
A therapist can diagnose you. Can I go to a therapist? Okay. How easy is it? Can I go and then...
BetterHelp.com.
Walk into the room with your dick in your hand.
Have them...
Bro.
Yeah. Have them diagnose my ball situation.
You could talk to your buzzball and it will tell you. If you talk to your buzzball...
Be like, hey, my right nut hurts all the time.
You have ADD.
Is it ADD or ball cancer?
Oh, boy.
Okay, so I've had like... I wish Kyle was here to help me out. God damn, this is the one episode I just really need Kyle here for me.
I like Kyle on all the episodes.
We talking BetterHelp? BetterHelp therapy?
It's not BetterHelp therapy, but gosh darn if it doesn't work.
Well, this is great, Blake. I like this. How long have you been doing this?
Dude, I've been going to therapy for a decade at least.
Even when we were doing Workaholics, you're going once a week?
Started, actually.
Yeah, that's what broke me, dude. I had to talk about you guys, son of a bitch.
Oh, boy.
Oh, wow, that's incredible. Should I start doing that? I don't know.
I've gone to therapy. You've got to go just to, like, see what it's all about.
Well, I'm rewatching Sopranos right now, and I'm like, I'm telling Chloe, I'm like, this looks kind of fun. I kind of want to go in.
Dude, it's a blast.
I feel like, Adam, you would just, like... I don't know.
Start entertaining the therapist?
I don't know. Part of me thinks maybe you go twice a month and then save that money and then use AC, so, like, sometimes.
Well, Adam, I often, like... Adam, that's a... Hey.
I just feel like I can't move in my house. I'm just so clammy.
I'm just
I feel
so
like
hot all the time.
Bullet.
I feel Adam. Like I'm so okay. hot all the time.
As your therapist, I don't want to tell you how to spend your money, but
yeah, it's true. But Adam, I what I have always loved about you, or what at least I like, I'm just like stoked for you. Is like you do have the ability to just be like. Let shit roll off your back. Like you're stoked on life all the time. Like it always feels like you find a way to positive spin.
But Blake, let's be honest. It rolls off his back, but then all that stuff builds up in his butt cheeks.
Get stuck on my ass.
Yeah, and that's why your balls are about to explode.
He has much anxiety now in the butt cheeks.
Yeah, dude.
All the tension has seeped into my asshole and then up through the asshole into my testicles.
Maybe.
That's the liquid that's in my right nut.
Adam, maybe you do need to just like fucking jab it and do a pressure release. I don't know, but maybe. I will say that like I admire the way... Like, that's what I get from your friendship is, like, sometimes you take me back to reality where it's, like, shit is not that as bad as you build up in your mind.
No, it never really is, for the most part, unless someone's dying. It usually isn't, yeah.
And then they die, and it's like, okay.
Yeah.
And then you're like, on to the next one.
My favorite Jay-Z song.
And then it's a Swizz Beatz versus. I'm looking it up.
You play that Jay-Z song and. And
dude,
you say, bummer. They're dead. Yeah. On to the next one. I got it, Millie, where you get it.
Dude, yeah, I don't know. It's. If you need to.
I think you do know. He just told you.
Yes. Well, if you need to talk about your shit, maybe that's like the second or third chapter of your life where you get introspective and you start to like really figure out like what the fuck's been going on. I don't know. Your life is such a hurricane of fucking look, you're so busy and all that shit. Mm-hmm. And maybe you want to touch down and think about it.
Maybe. Yeah, I could see doing it. I'm not opposed to it or anything. I've just always been like, I just did. I haven't felt like I needed it. But but during when my dad was sick and, you know, there's just like a lot of things stacking up.
Yeah, dude, when shit gets heavy.
I was like, oh, maybe I do need to talk to someone. And then I just didn't. But yeah.
And your butt got bigger.
And then your balls exploded.
My ass just grew two sizes. I couldn't fit into a suit this past week.
Huh. Here's your sign.
But yeah, no, I think it's cool. I don't think it's bad at all. I just.
No, I don't think you. I'm not saying you guys think it's bad. It's just like I don't know. It's just as we get older, and then like real life shit is just always on the horizon now.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I think it's helpful when you become a parent. It's helpful to understand more about yourself, and so then you know how to like what you would do to like raise your kids differently than you were raised, or like when you feel certain impulses, you just know when.
Yeah,
to
you're like
blame your parents.
So my dad used to hit me with a belt. Yeah. Is that good or not?
Yeah,
dude. I remember I told my therapist, I was like, dude, all we're gonna do is like shit on my parents. I don't want to do it anymore. Like this is stupid. Like I don't blame them because I love my mom and dad. I think they freaking rock. I think they did the best they could. But like they're like. But they're like, it's not about shitting on them. It's just like that was the way they programmed you, and they were probably programmed a certain way. And all therapy does is like understand how you're programmed, maybe reprogramming, whatever.
So do you have a relationship like Tony Soprano had with his? This is the most I know about.
Right.
Is Tony Soprano talking to his therapist?
Yes.
I think it's exactly like that for everybody.
Is it exactly? Yeah. You like, you kind of want to fuck him.
At one point you've kissed.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
No, I haven't had a therapist that I've been with forever. I wish I could say like, yo, man. I got the guy or whatever. I've got a decade worth of work with this person, and they've just been absolutely perfect for me. But I don't know. Sometimes it could just be like a one-off where it's just somebody listening to you and like asking you questions that other people don't ask you. Like
I'll ask you.
Yeah. Well, I get it. It's especially talking to like a.
Give me a call.
Well, Durs would.
I'm not trying to talk to you, Durs.
Dude, I would love being a therapist.
Durs would be actually a good therapist because he would just go right to your core every fucking time.
Yeah, dude. There's a bit of that. Like it might feel cold blooded, but sometimes they just gotta like just put the mirror in your face.
They have the soundboard and they just keep hitting it. They keep going, oh yeah, the bitch. You're like, okay, yep. I guess I was being a bitch.
I gotta keep it 100. I do.
Do not come.
I would love to be a therapist and be like, yeah, just don't do that.
Definitely. And I feel like that's how I would be a therapist too. I'd be like, well, just don't.
It's been 10 minutes. You can go.
Just don't overeat then.
Yeah.
If that's your problem, just stop doing that.
Okay. So then, as your patient, when I do that, then all of a sudden I'm like, fuck, why am I such a fuck up, dude? Like my therapist told me, all you have to do is not do that. Why did I do that?
Well, it's not doing it 80% of the time. You know what I mean? It's like...
Yeah, it's a lot of forgiving yourself.
You can do cocaine, just not all the time, dude.
Constantly.
You could do hard drugs, just not all the time.
You'd be a great... You're a great therapist, Adam. You're a great therapist.
If you cannot do that stuff 80% of the time, you're probably in pretty good shape.
Yeah,
you're doing
man.
Good.
Welcome to Adam's Couch, where Adam tells you just don't do that 80% of the time.
Just don't do it like 85% of the time.
We're taking your calls live now. Hey,
whatever you do, don't walk in a room with a dick in your hand. Just don't.
I've got an eating disorder. I can't help it. What do I do?
But do you eat too much or you don't eat at all?
I can't stop eating.
I eat too much and then I go and I purge. What do I do?
Okay. I eat because I'm unhappy.
Okay. Well, you're going to want fake teeth because I bet your teeth are gross as fuck. I bet they're like brown.
Awesome.
And then also mouthwash for sure. You're going to want that. And then also just don't eat that much. Just don't eat that much.
80% of the time?
I would say 80% of the time don't eat.
I was just waiting for the thing we talked about for 10 minutes. I'm like, oh, and so your Snapchat bit is never. Nope, not gonna do it.
No. I would say like maybe 5 days of the week don't eat a ton, and then on the weekend you can just kind of do whatever you want.
Thank you, God.
Yeah.
Thank you, God.
Yeah, on the weekend you can do cocaine, go to orgies, and eat at buffets.
Well, I feel
like we just found out what Blake was going for. I was going to orgies and buffets. All right, well, maybe don't do that 80% of the time.
Yeah, if just 80% of the time, you just don't do that, and then you just pick one day to go to orgies and eat at buffets.
I wish my shit was that exciting. I just have ADD.
Yeah, right. Just Blake can't concentrate. Shit.
I just can't get my calendar right.
I mean, did you get on pills for that?
Well, that's the thing is.
Oh, can I get your Addy? Can you hook me up? I wouldn't mind.
Because in college, they put me on that shit.
I wouldn't mind an Adderall plug.
Hell yeah.
I feel like I've said this on the pod. In college, they were like, why are you so stupid? And I was like, I don't know. And then they put me on something, Ritalin or whatever the other ones are. Mm-hmm. And I like shot through the roof.
Yeah.
And was like, this is crazy. And then I just gave him away to like.
Do you think you were, you think you're misdiagnosed? Like you don't have ADD?
That's Mr. Diagnosed to you.
Well, if you, isn't it right if you have ADD, Adderall like levels you out, right?
Yeah, exactly.
It makes you like chill and you're able to just concentrate and like, you know, how a normal person. But if you don't, because.
If you're just stupid, it turns out to be cocaine. Yeah.
Yeah. Which is why I loved it.
No, that's what my therapist said. She was like, yo, hey, like you like cocaine, don't you? And I'm like, no, actually, I don't at all. And she's like,
and then she was like, oh, forget it then, because I was just, you wanted to hang out.
Oh, she had a tray of it. See? Oh, never mind.
You like cocaine, don't you? I'm good.
I would like to make out with you. Right. She's like, this is a Zoom. This is a Zoom.
Yeah. You're a fucking bummer.
You are my guma now.
Dude, I don't know. I don't know. So to answer your question, Durs, I did not get any medication because one of my main fucking hangups, and I know this is like something that everybody's trying to dispel nowadays, is like
air conditioning.
I don't want to use air conditioning, and I don't want to take a medication that will change who I am because part of me really thinks like the reason I'm humorous or who I am is because my brain is chemically imbalanced.
Can I tell you something? No.
You're not funny.
can I tell you something? I know what you mean. I know what you mean because it's like, okay, so if I change like a fundamental thing about me, which makes me me.
That I've been for almost 40 years.
Right. But then you'll be just an unfunny good person.
Like, yeah.
So what's the trade-off? You're like,
No, yeah, but that would suck.
I'm not a bad person.
You'll be like a nice truck driver. No. But you're a different person.
Yeah.
You'll just be a truck driver with zero jokes.
Yeah.
Yes, points.
So what is the ADD? Is that why you can't, like you're such a bad driver? Is that like part of it?
Oh, no. Yeah. Well, I'm not a bad driver. Well, maybe.
Yeah, you are.
Yeah,
like you direction, are a bad, like direction, like sense of direction.
That's part of driving. Yes,
yeah. It's possible.
I mean, you're not hitting stuff all the time. You're not like bad and like
that we know of.
You know how to drive a car, but like you do when we're all going to the same place, which happens. It used to happen all the time when we were on Workaholics. We'd all be like, okay, we're all going to take our cars and we're all meet there. And then it would be like Durs and I are there. And then 15, 20 minutes later, you'd pull up and you're like, how'd you guys get here? And we're like, we just drove straight here.
Yeah.
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 And you would just take like the loop-de-doo route or what?
This is the way.
Well, that's also because I kind of drive like a grandma.
Well, like, you do, but
I drive very slow in the slow lane. I'm just not in a rush to places.
I would love passing you on the freeway on the way to work. I'd be like, well, there goes Blake. And I'm just like,
see ya, sucker.
But also, dude, you want to know why? Where the hell? Remember, we all left one house. I think it's while we were actually house hunting for Hamlin. All five of us.
For the Workaholics house.
Yes.
Yeah.
Adam, Haley, me, you, and Kyle, we all took separate cars to go look at a house somewhere. Like, I think it might have been Culver City.
And you're worried about air conditioning with the environment? Go ahead.
this was a while back. This is before global warming.
This was before he cared, before he became a climate warrior. Right. Before global warming, 10 years ago.
Now we're at the brink of destruction, but this is where...
Because of you.
Mm-hmm.
But I got a speeding ticket because I hit the gas because we were going to be late to the showing.
So you got a speeding ticket one time and now you can't drive the speed limit?
Yeah,
he's triggered.
It fucking got me, dude. The cop smacked my hand and I said, yes, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah, dude. Sorry.
Mm. Well, that's cool. That's cool that you're... I wonder if I have ADD. I do. I might have ADD.
Well, I know a lot. That's the thing is also.
But I don't because Adderall doesn't affect me in a positive, normal way. I love it in the fact that it just gives me a ton of energy and I'm like.
I don't think you can say I don't have this because this drug doesn't affect me that way. But
okay,
I think
okay, doctor.
There's an indicator.
Dr. Buzzballz.
Dr. Brozarks.
I don't even know, man. Because I know that a lot of people will be like, oh, we all have ADD. Or like, oh, all of a sudden everybody is being diagnosed with these things that we never used to have.
Right. Mm-hmm.
But like... I don't know, man.
I mean, we're all doing self-analyzing, whatever.
We're looking
in our anuses more than anybody. I was talking to my parents the other day, and I was like, because one of our kids is just wiling out now that school started, transition, whatever. It's wild. Mm-hmm. And I was like, did you and Dad ever talk about when I was wiling out? And she was like, no, we never really talked about parenting. And I was like,
yeah,
sick. Dude, what a different era.
Dude, we're just on the fucking crack of the generation of parenting that did not really go in and analyze anything.
Ever.
Yeah, it was just dude, just go play. Just go play.
Yeah, I feel like we are the millennials are the last generation that their parents really didn't.
And it wasn't that they didn't care. I think our parents all loved us.
I'm Gen X.
Yeah, they just didn't know. They just didn't know. Like my parents never talked about how to raise me. They were just like, yeah, go play in the alleyway.
Right.
Yeah.
Go ride your bike somewhere and just get out of my hair for a few hours.
Yeah, right. It was main concern, don't die.
Don't get kidnapped.
Whatever doesn't kill you.
Your ass is on and popping even then.
Right.
Whatever doesn't kill you makes you stronger and you're going to come back a strong boy.
Adam was so... Adam, the fact that you weren't kidnapped is insane.
It is.
Dude, it's crazy.
A little boy with that bubble butt.
With that fucking just sticking out, just wiggling and waggling.
How did somebody not...
Licking a lolly?
Just slurping down a bomb pop. Just deep throating a bomb.
How did somebody not scoop your little fleshlight ass up? And
I don't know, dude. It's fucking absurd. It is absurd.
God damn, you're lucky, man. You're lucky.
Honestly.
Oof.
Honestly. Oof. I don't know. I mean, I don't think I was that cute of a kid, honestly. I think I looked like a little hedgehog, I had a little mullet. I had some sidesteps. I feel I wasn't.
But that was regional. That's regional for you.
It was that ass that they would have had to zero in on that. Mm-hmm.
Mouth.
I was wearing big Tasmanian devil shirts, and they might have covered it.
God, you're like describing my dream woman.
I mean, can you
big
imagine?
Big ass Taz shirt. Hey, baby. Let's hit the club, baby.
The way Adam's booty looked in those Zubaz pants, can you imagine?
Let's just say I filled out the MC Hammer pants.
Oh, man. Should we do take backs?
The only guy that can fill out a parachute pants.
Should we do take backs and lookalikes while we're still feeling good?
Not lookalikes, dead ringers.
Dead ringers in honor of Kyle.
Dead ringers.
Who gave the best Emmy speech a couple weeks ago.
Yes. Mm. That was good.
We think. We're not sure.
We don't know. Secret.
Freaking see ya.
Not sure. Didn't watch it. No, not a fan. Didn't watch it.
Blake, did you want to just, this is prescient. Prescient. Do you want to say some words about Queen Elizabeth, Blake?
Oh, yeah, like a couple weeks later. Honestly, I think this, the whole Queen Elizabeth thing was so, like...
Thing?
Hot take.
Like her life, or what do you mean? Like, what do you mean?
Her whole angle?
Her dude, 96 it was just years like, of life, or what?
I think it was just, like, very eye-opening to the way everything is moving as a society. When Queen Elizabeth died... Like, I think, like, news networks was like, oh, yeah, this is going to be a hot news day because we're going to really honor her and all this shit. And it's going to just be like, dude, she's 96. We've been building up to this. But then, like, social media was just dunking on her so hard, they really were. Dude.
Like, woman. What? What'd they say? I didn't see it.
Oh, dude, it's just like...
You're too old for the internet matters.
Yeah, dude, she's just beginning. You've hit that age. Ran through on all social media. Like everything is just like.
What's one example? I mean, I know you got to dig back 2 weeks.
When I said like dunking, it was literally like they had like a photoshopped like Charles' head on like DeAndre Jordan dunking on that one dude and turning that into Queen Elizabeth. So it's like just like nuts on her head. Like
so literally dunking.
Yes.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
They were literally dunking on her. Uh-huh. I saw the one which made me giggle was where it's the Undertaker. And it was...
he rises up.
Yeah. It was when Meghan Markle, Markle visits Queen Elizabeth at the viewing, and then she just
comes
like
back.
Snatches her neck and comes back alive.
Dude, yeah. It's just so
and
weird.
I don't even get what that means because I don't know anything about these people, but I laughed at it. I think she must not like that girl from Suits, but...
By the end, I think it was like, well, I don't know. It gets all into like, it was like the interracial marriage of it, and then like, the queen evidently wasn't hyped on it, so like everybody's like,
her words,
fuck her.
I'm just not hyped on this interracial.
I'm not hyped on this matrimony. I'll die before I see my boy in an interracial marriage. And then they assassinated her.
I'm just not hyped.
Doesn't Meghan Markle have like a talk show now? We gotta get on that.
I hope so. We need her on the pod.
Dude, the fact that she hasn't hit us up right away.
Isn't that weird?
I think she owns BuzzBallz.
Well, the crazy part about Meghan Markle is like, we could just know her.
Merkel.
She was, whatever her name is, we could just know her. She was just like an actress who was like the sixth lead on Suits.
You probably like had a Leslie Kahn class with her, Adam, and don't even remember.
I bet I did. I bet I was in an acting class. I bet you were in an acting class.
I know I
was. I bet she auditioned for Workaholics. I bet we could go in the crates.
She might have.
Dude, that would be amazing.
And she's just like...
She might have.
Playing like... She was going to play the stripper that winked her butthole at me in the Playdasium at Dante's Pizza Palace.
Or she might have been Alice. She might have been Alice, dude.
Yeah.
Who knows?
Alice Markle.
Alice Markle. Hey, guys, that was another episode of...
Jersey, did you have any take back?
Important.
Oh, did you have a take back? Did I blow it?
Oh, I got a million ways to get it.
Louder.
This is me and therapy right here.
Now double your money and make a stack.
On to the next one. On to the next one. Dang, that came in hot.
Yeah, it does. That song fucking rocks.
Wow.